In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to properly crop your picture for the DV Lottery 2022. And this is coming up. Hello everybody, it's Innocent here. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, please hit on the subscribe button. If you're old here, thank you so much for showing up. So this is the website that we're going to use. I'll leave a link in the description in case you want to follow that. But before then, I want you to understand that this is straight from the travel state department. So everything, every information that I'll be giving you is from this official website. I'm not making up things and everything is from the official website. So I'm going to leave all the links in the description. So first of all, let's take a look at a very quick look at what we are to expect or what are the instructions or the requirements for the DV Lottery picture 2022. So when you go to the travelstate.government under the DV22 program instructions, you find the PDF over there. I'll try and leave the PDF link in the description as well. So all that you need to do is to click on the PDF link and then it is going to take you to the instructions. Mind you, this requirement covers the entire program, that is the program overview, starting right from the eligibility. But then we are not going to take time to go through all this. Like I said, I'll leave the PDF so you can read it for yourself. Now let's scroll down to where we have the picture section. So when you go down, you should have the picture section over here. So that is the submitting a digital photo. Let me go up here, submitting a digital photograph, and this is what this video is about. So what are you required in your photo? In the previous years, you could actually apply with the same image, and people have been applying with the same image continuously because they feel like that was the perfect image. But in this year's requirement, you are not supposed to use a picture that was taken more than 6 months ago, and you're not to repeat a picture that you used in the previous. So if you applied last 2 years, you can't use the same picture to apply for this picture. I think aside that, the rest of the things are almost the same. It has to be in color, in focus. The size, it has to be 600 by 600 pixels, not more than 240 kilobytes. And then you shouldn't be wearing glasses. You shouldn't have earpiece, and so you can read all these one. Now if you want even more clearer, you can review the photo examples over here. So let me click on that and let's see some of the picture examples. So this is how your picture is supposed to look like, but then you have to also make sure that it is void of any shadows casted at the back, and it has to be on a plain white background. And oh, before you forget, the registration starts tomorrow, that is the 7th of October 2020, and I'll be making a step-by-step tutorial on how to apply it. So you have to subscribe and keep the bell notifications on so that once it is up, you see the video, and that will be very much appreciated. So let's quickly go to the egreenphoto.com and let's see the process. It is very simple, just that you have to take time to do it. The first thing that you need to do is you make sure that whilst you're taking the picture, you leave a bit of space between the size of the picture and above the head. This is because we're going to crop into it the more. So if you crop your picture to be very much closer, let's say something like this, you might not actually have the chance to recrop it again. So in order to do that, you can use a software like Photoshop or Canva or Photopia or Affinity Design to make sure that once you take the picture, you have a bit of space at the end of the size and above the head. And once this is done, you just go to your website, that is eGreenCardPhoto, and then you go to upload. You're going to navigate to the picture section and then you're going to select your picture and then you wait for it to upload. Once your picture is done uploading, you should see something like this, and you realize that the reason why I said you should leave a bit of space around it is because now we have our image cropped perfectly. Now you have to make sure that it is in compliance with this particular one, that is the edge of the chin, and then the top of the head must be inside the green rectangle. So you can actually crop in the more to make sure that it fits as it's stated, like that. So the edge of the chin, like this, my image for instance, the first green is on her chin, and then the other one Here it says the head, so it's on the head, and that means this fits perfectly to be used for the entry. So after this, all that you need to do is you go ahead and you click OK. Now this is what it is going to look like on your permanent resident card. And then the next thing that you do is you go ahead and then you click OK. So this is going to download to your download location. In this case, I have mine on my desktop, so when I go to my desktop, this is my image. Now to make sure that it is in compliance with the sizes, the 600 by 600, you can just first place your cursor on top of your image, and then you see that the dimension is 600 by 600, and then the size is 59.3 kilobytes, which is obviously lesser than 240 kilobytes, or even more. You can click on it, right click on it, and go to your image properties, and then you should see the size over there, 59.3 kilobytes, or the one that reflects on the disk is 60 points, which is obviously lesser than 240. When you go to the details as well, you're going to see the dimensions over here, which says that 600 by 600 pixels, which is very perfect for the entry. Now even when you have a software like Photoshop and then you drag this one in here, you realize that when you go to image and then image size, it gives you 2 by 2 inches, which is stated in the requirement, and then the 600 by 600 pixels. So this was the actual image, and this is the cropped image that you can use. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for sticking around to watch. Don't forget that the registration starts on 7th October. I'm making a dedicated video on that, but if you want to just know a glimpse of how it looks like, you can check the video that I did last 2 years on how to register for the DV lottery. The only difference this year is the inclusion of a passport, which I didn't cover in the 2018 version. So once the link is up, God's willing, tomorrow I'm going to make a step-by-step video. Be sure to subscribe so that when the video is up, you see it. I wish each and everyone the very best of luck in this year's entry. I hope you get selected, and I'll see you on the other side. Thank you so much once again for watching. I'll see you in the next video. It's Innocent here, and bye.